Sports Director Matt McCoy joins me and on the Diamonds Direct Live line right now. Matt Sauk, your head coach for your Columbus Destroyers. Matt, how are you this morning?
I'm doing great. How are you doing?
Doing great. I'll tell you what, seems like you got a lot of work ahead of you here. I know you've named a couple guys to the team, but you're playing ball pretty quick, aren't you?
Yeah, we start camp starts April 5th. Our first game is April 27th, and our first home game is May 18th.
So people that have seen arena football in Columbus in the past, are the Destroyers, this league this time around, is it going to be a lot different or no?
No, it's going to be the same. You know, same, you know, fast action pace, you know, type of football where the fans get a chance to be close to the action. It should be fun.
Yeah, and when you talk about that, I mean, Columbus has a great tradition of football fans. And when you look now at, you know, the Blue Jackets in town, the Crew in town, all the things going on, it seems like this might be one of the better times to try to do something like this. Are you getting a lot of support from the community?
Yeah, without a doubt. There's a ton of people that are interested in this. And, you know, the great thing about it is that it's affordable for the family. And that's important.
Yeah, you know, people love their football coach in Columbus, Ohio. And it's interesting, I've been watching the free agent signings that you've had this week, and there are guys that probably aren't like household names, and I'll raise my hand too, in terms of, you know, knowing them, but you sign guys like Varma Soni, Donovan Morgan, Larico Stevenson. Talk a little bit about the team that you're assembling this week with these free agent signings and names that football fans and Destroyer fans are going to get to know over these coming months.
Yeah, you know, those three, I'm sorry, that you just, you know, said are guys that are all arena guys. And that's important. You know, another guy that we signed is Kareem Smith. And in 2017, he was the Defensive Player of the Year. So, you know, these are guys that, you know, we believe in. And, you know, most of them are on the defense right now just because, you know, we felt like that was an important step for us as an expansion team is to have a great defense. And, you know, one of those guys is Nick Cedar, who is an Ohio native. And that, again, to me was important is that we get guys that, you know, are from that area as well. So, you know, I like what we've signed so far. I feel like we've really put together a great defense. We're just piecing together the offense now, and one of those guys was obviously Donovan Morgan. And that, again, was a guy who's an all-arena performer, you know, took some time off and is ready to come back and you know, show that he still has it too.
And I saw you got a quarterback too, Greg McGee. Where are you in terms of, and Joel was asking about building a roster, how far along are you and how important are, like, I know you have player tryouts, people can try out on March 23rd. How important is that in terms of building your roster?
I mean, it's big. I mean, like I said, we can't always see everyone. And, you know, this is a great opportunity for people, you know, not only in Ohio, but, you know, you got Michigan and the surrounding states to kind of come in and show what they have. You know, because, again, we can't see everything. You know, we're not the NFL where we have, you know, thousands and thousands of, you know, hours of tape to watch and being able to do that at this point.
Yeah, you mentioned, Matt, you're just talking about, you know, these are arena guys. We've watched the combines, the guys putting up, you know, low 4 second 40s. Is that what it's about? Because the field's so much smaller, you just got to be like, it's not necessarily about being fast, but it's about being quick.
Yeah, I mean, it does help without a doubt. I mean, you don't have to be a 4.3 guy in the arena because, like you said, it's smaller. So for me, I need guys who are quick, can get out of their breaks, you know, really fast, and, you know, again, are able to adjust to the small field.
You're coming in as head coach behind a couple of guys that here at the radio station we know and love a lot, Earl Bruce, Chris Spielman. When you look at coaching arena league football in Columbus, do you look at what guys before you have done and try to take little bits and pieces of that?
Yeah, always. I mean, it's something I've always done as a coordinator. You want to always learn from the people before you, and that's something that's important. And, you know, Spielman is a guy that, you know, I was a Lions fan. So, I mean, that guy was a Lions, you know, was a Lions guy that just dominated. And, you know, to me, it's like if you don't learn from the people in front of you, you know, you never really have a chance to be successful.
You talked about, you know, the affordability of going to see arena football. It's going to be in Nationwide Arena. How special that's a beautiful arena, and we love it in Columbus. Just how special is it to have a facility like that at your disposal to play your games in this year, Coach?
I mean, it's great. It's first class. I had a chance to see it when we went there for the press conference, and it's just a beautiful arena. And I cannot wait to see, you know, 10,000, 12,000 fans, whatever we get on that first game, and just see that thing packed. Because it is. I mean, it's a first class facility.
Okay, now I know you're the head coach, and so you're worried about building a roster and winning football games. But Captain Destroyer, they're putting out tryouts for the mascot on March 30th, looking for a female mascot to represent the Columbus Destroyers. Do you have your fingerprints on that as well, Coach, or is that up to other people to decide the Captain Destroyer mascot?
That is definitely above my pay grade. I absolutely love it. You know, I've got two girls, and you know, to be able to have a female destroyer is awesome. Because again, we want to make sure that we are a family friendly team. We want to make sure that we include everyone, and that's important. And girls are, you know, my girls love football. They watch NFL with me on Sunday. You know, they're interested in what I'm doing. And to me, like I said, this is a first, and this is awesome. I love it to death.
Yeah, 12-game regular season going to open at Albany on Saturday, the 27th of April, and then rocking here the home field May 4th against Atlantic City. I mean, other than the Destroyers, what are the teams we should keep our eyes out for as far as top quality arena football this year, Coach?
Well, you know, Philadelphia is good every single year, and you know, they have a great quarterback in Dan Rodabaugh. Baltimore will be good again. And, you know, for us, like I said, my biggest thing that I want to do is make sure that we, you know, got quality players. And I feel like we've done that. And I think we'll be able to compete with these teams that, you know, have been around for a while.
I got it. Well, keep an eye out for the Ohio State guys. Keep that Michigan shirt in the drawer, and we should be okay.
Yes, sir. Without a doubt.
All right. Matt, have a great season. I hope
Thanks, Coach. Talk
throughout it. That's good stuff, Matt.
Best of luck to you.
He is the head coach for your Columbus Destroyers right there.